Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 13. Today, while I'll be showcasing basic edits in Lightroom, I'll also be demonstrating the importance of cropping and post-crop vignetting to creating a more compelling final image. For those of you familiar with my blog, you may recognize from a previous post this delightful cafe in Georgetown in Washington, D.C. This photo was shot on a different day from that previous post. My eye today was drawn to the gentleman in the turquoise t-shirt in the window, and so I sat myself down across the street and waited for a photographic opportunity, which included no cars and, of course, pedestrians, and this woman on her cell phone provided one. Now, the day was cloudy, and I want to begin by just bringing the exposure down just a bit more because of this brighter area of the photo to the left. So I'm just going to bring this down a little bit. It will be more pleasing to my eye, just a touch. And so that's where I began, with decreasing the exposure. The next step is I'm coming down and I'm going to open up the shadows. I want to see that the detail that I can capture from inside the cafe. So I'll come to the shadows slider and I'm going to open up the shadows by sliding the slider to the right. And you can see the brightness of the interior. The next, as I look at my histogram, I have not set any blackest levels in the file. So I'm going to come down and I'm going to hit my black slider. And there's a method that you can use by hitting Alt on your keyboard. And when I drag the slider, you'll see the areas that show black are the ones where black is being deposited. And if you come back and let go of Alt, you will see in these blue areas where shadow clipping is occurring. And of course, this is way too much. You lose detail in shadow clipping. I just want to bring it down to where a black point is just barely established without losing detail in critical areas. So I'm going to leave it, that looks about right, probably about there. And then I will uncheck. I will hide shadow clipping. Next, I want to use the clarity adjustment and enhance the fine detail in the picture. A good starting point is 15 to 20. So I'm going to boost this up. And I think I'm going to leave it about 23. And then vibrance. I tend to, with street shots, oftentimes I feel that they're better a little bit with a little bit less vibrance. So I'm going to bring this down in the other direction. And it's personal preference, but this is where, this is a setting for this photo that I happen to like. Next, I'm going to come down to the detail panel and I'm going to apply my sharpening preset. I come over here to the left and I click on, this does happen to be a JPEG, sharpen JPEG. And you'll see the values change. Now that I've finished sharpening, the last detail for the photo is to crop it. And to do that, I come up to the crop overlay tool. And there are a number of different overlays in Photoshop, and you can cycle through them by pressing the O on your keyboard, and it will bring up different, as I said, different overlays. There is the golden spiral. There's just a grid to help you straighten. This is the rule of thirds. This is the golden. So these are the diagonals, and then there's the golden triangles. And not all of them will work on each photo. At least that's what I have found. But You can also, as you cycle through by pressing O, if you press Shift when you hit a specific overlay and then hit O, you will see that it will change the orientation of each. So there's the golden spiral in different positions. If I go to, let's see, the triangle, the golden triangle, and I hit Shift, it will rotate it. I guess that's 90 degrees or 180 degrees. You see how good I am at math. This one, for this picture, I'm going to go back to the rule of thirds and see what that gives me. So on the rule of thirds, I'm going to, and for the most part, I do not, because I don't print my pictures, I unlock the aspect ratio. So I can do what I wish to with the photo. If I'm going to use golden spiral, I will come in and I will choose the specific ratio to which the golden spiral is applicable. But generally, otherwise, I leave it unlocked. So on this, I'm going to unlock it and I'm just going to pull. And I'd like to really focus my attention on the woman. And so I'm going to crop out the side buildings for the most part. I'm going to pull in over here. And you'll oftentimes see I can't, even with pulling down the top, if I wanted to get one of the intersecting points on her head, for example, I'm going to lose too much of the photo. And even coming back up, I want to obviously keep in the awning. If I was to move it, the bottom intersection point up, even to say her purse, I would still want to move this up a little bit more, otherwise the photo is too narrow. But then it brings in, if I come down here to show done, it brings in too much extraneous detail for me. My eye is drawn outside the picture. So I'm going to come back to the overlay and I'm going to pull back down, and I'll show you. I pulled back down here and I'm going to click done so you can see the change. It's a funny aspect ratio, and I'm still not pleased with it. Back to the crop overlay, and sometimes you just have to play with the rules a little bit. So while the intersecting points aren't on her head or the purse, I'm going to place her, kind of just make sure she's on the line. And let me come back out and click done and see what I think of that. And I actually like that. She is on the line, on the rule of thirds. I have cut out most of the extraneous detail, but here's the last point that I want to make. It's still, my eye is still not as drawn to the center of the picture as I would like, even with the crop. So this is where, and this is why I use post-crop vignetting a great deal. It helps to lead your eye to the point in the picture where the photographer wants it to go. So on this one, I'm going to come over and I'm going to play with some of my presets. My vignette 2 is my heaviest preset. It really darkens up the corners. But I can also play with the midpoint and the roundness and the feathering. So I'm going to start with the 35, and I may actually bring it down just a bit more to 40, say 45. And then the midpoint, as I play with the slider, you'll see how it moves in and out. And the default is 50, but I want to bring it in just a little bit more. So I'm going to leave it about there. And then roundness, I'm going to, again, I will come out. It will change the shape. It may be hard to see. I'm going to bring in this feather so you can see the hard edges. I can slide this back and forth, and I can make it different shapes, and I can bring it in closer or just move it to the edges. So on this, I think Whoops, I'm going to bring it in, make it just a little round, bring it in from the edges a bit more. And then in terms of feathering, that's the demarcation between the shadowing or the vignetting and the photo. And obviously, unless you're really trying to create a harsh vignette, feathering is a good idea. This kind of vignette here may be a fun use for a portrait, but for me and for most, feathering just gives it a nice transition. So I'm going to bring this out to about here. And we'll let Lightroom think for a minute, get that all settled in, and I think that's where I would like to leave it. So let me come back and I will show you in history, look at all those steps, on the beginning. There's the before. And there's the after. And it certainly focuses my eye on the action within the cafe, the woman walking, and I just happen to like it. That was, in fact, the focus of my photo. So you can play around with your crop overlays and see the different effects that they give and see what you come up with and what you like the most, what works best for you in the photo. I hope you've enjoyed this week's video. Please, if you have any questions about the process or about anything I've shown here, ask in the comments section. And to see more post-processing videos and after before photos, visit visualventuring.com and select After Before Friday Forum in the menu. Thanks for watching.